Hello my YouTube friends, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can be able to connect the Bible Show to the Prism Life Studio. And the Bible Show is a scripture display software that you can use to display your scriptures both on lower third and in full screen as well. And I'm going to show you how you can be able to connect this particular software into your Prism Life Studio. If you're just coming across the channel for the first time or you haven't subscribed, smash that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, do me a quick favor, smash that like button below so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend this video to other people on the YouTube community that would want to be part of our little family here on this channel. And without any further ado, let's jump right into the tutorial. Now the first thing you're going to do is to go ahead and install the Bible Show software. I also dropped the link in the description below. Click on that, get straight to this webpage, and you can be able to download the Bible Show software. Now once you're done installing it, for those of you that are still wondering, how do I make use of the Bible Show software, how do I navigate my way around, how do I change the background, how do I use the lower third, what do I need to know, I've also done a comprehensive video on that, on how you can be able to use the Bible Show software, how you can navigate your way, how you can change background, how you can do so many cool stuff using the Bible Show software. I also dropped the link in the description below. Go ahead and check it out. Then you can learn how you can be able to use the Bible Show software just like a pro that you are. Now, once you've already done installing the Bible Show software, open it on your PC. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and open mine. And once you've opened the Bible Show software, also open the Prism Life software, which is the one that we are also going to be making use of as well. Okay, so I'm just going to minimize this one here, minimize the Bible Show, and open the Prism Life Studio software as well. Okay, just give it some seconds for it to load. So the Prism Life Studio, is up, and I have my Bible Show software up as well. Now on the Bible Show software, just pop in any scripture that you want to use on the screen. Okay, I'm just going to pop in any scripture that you want to use on the screen. Now on it, you see the themes here. On the option tab, you see the themes, configure, preferences, and Bibles. Now click on the configure tab. On the configure tab, you see the display. Now there are two displays here, display one and display two. Now we're going to be using the display one. Now from the destination, untick this display windows and tick the NDI output. Now if you see here, tick the NDI output and untick the display windows. Now once you've already done this, scroll down on the appearance, change this horizontal resolution to 1920 here, and then the vertical resolution to 1080. Now change it to 1080. And once you're done, just go back to the themes. Okay, from the themes here, you can select any theme that you want to use. Now how about if you want to use a lower third theme, we'll also get to that as well. And pop in any scripture that you want to use on the screen, just any scripture at all. Once you already popped in your scripture, go back to the Prism Life Studio here. And once you already popped in your scripture, go back to the Prism Life Studio. Now on the Prism Life Studio, you see the scenes, you see the sources. Now click on this add button on the sources here, which is the plus sign there you've seen. Click on it and then go over to NDI source. Select the NDI source and click on OK. And from here you can name this Bible Display. Okay, the Bible Display, which is the name. Click on OK. And then on the select sources, click on that. You're going to see the whatever name of your PC and then Bible Show NDI. Select the Bible Show NDI and click on OK. And there you go. You have the Bible Show beautifully displayed on the screen for you. Now, you wouldn't want this to interrupt your main video. Now, all you have to do is to create a separate scene for it and then a separate scene for your camera that you're using. Now, on the Bible Show scene, also click on this add button and bring in the audio capture that you're using on your main scene, that is your camera scene, so that anytime you pop in the scripture on the screen, you'll be able to hear the man of God audio or whichever background audio, maybe the person reading the scripture at that particular moment, and as the man of God is talking as well, they can be able to hear them as well, while the scripture will also be displayed on the screen. You see this plus sign here, mic and audio capture. Click on it and select, click on OK, and then from here you can select any mic that you have that you're using on your main camera and pop it in on the screen as well. So anytime you pop the scripture here on your life, you can be able to hear his audio. That's the man of God audio, and those watching too can be able to hear his audio as well. And when you want to switch back to your main camera, click on that and there you go. You can switch back and forth between the two of them. Now how about if you want to use lower thought for it? Let me also show you how to do that as well. And go back to the Bible Show software. Now on the themes here, you see the themes, click on the themes and you see the download button there. Now click on the download button here, and from here you see the select package themes collection. Click on the select package themes collection and go over to themes collection 6, which is the themes that contains the lower thought. Now if you want to also learn how you can be able to use your own custom lower thought, I did a comprehensive guide on how you can navigate your way through in the Bible Show software. Now the link is in the description, check it out and you can learn how you can be able to create your own custom lower thought and use on Bible Show. Now you see these are the list of lower thought that you have here. Click on download and install. Just going to download it. See, downloading themes collection 06.exe. So it's currently downloading the themes collection here. Okay, so I'm just going to give you some seconds for it to load. My internet is not really that fast, but just give it just a second for it to load so that you can be able to download the lower thought that we want to make use of in place of the full scripture display. And boom, it has already installed the themes collection 6. And go back to the theme, scroll down till you see the lower thought that you just downloaded. Okay, to see the lower thought that you just downloaded, select any of the lower thought. See, okay, I'm not saving this previous one here. I have select any of the lower thought here. You can see here, just pop in any of the lower thought that you want to use and select a Bible scripture. And there you go, see the lower thought here on the screen. And go back to the Prism Live Studio, you see the lower thought also reflecting on the screen. Now this way it won't cover the screen when the man of God is preaching. You also have it on lower thought so that the camera can show the man of God and it can also show the lower thought. Now if you're using it like this, you might want to just click on this plus button here, which is the add button here, and bring in your main camera into the Bible Show scene so they can be able to switch back and forth with your main camera. Okay, so and this is how it's going to look like on the screen so that those watching online can be able to read along to the scripture as well. Okay, and this is how to be able to use the Bible Show software and connect it to your Prism Live Studio. In case you love this video and find it helpful and you haven't subscribed, please smash that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this. And if you have any requests for me, let me know in the comment section below. I also have my website portheki.com live. You can also send me your question from there too as well. And I have the Telegram group and the Telegram channel. Go ahead and join our Telegram group for discussions, and you can also learn more from other streamers. Okay, thank you and see you in our next video.